Hello friends, this is Shravan. This is my YouTube channel Civil Engineering by Shravan. To subscribe my channel, click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates. In this video lecture, I will explain you analysis and designing of G+1 building by using ETAP software. So initially, I will show you the model for the respected plan for ground story as well as first story for this respected house. Go to this G+1 folder. Click on plan. So go to ground floor plan. So this is my ground floor plan. It will be consisting of double bedroom hall kitchen portion. So again, I will open first floor plan. So this is my first floor plan, which is in north facing direction. So I was already explained complete details about the ground floor plan and first floor plan in my previous video. I will provide you the plan explanation link in this video description as well as above card. Please watch that video initially. So this plan will be consisting of 12 number of columns here. So I will design the respected G+1 building of north story in this ETAP software tutorial. So go to click on ETAP software. The software will be open like this. Click on file option. So here we need to select new model. So it will open the options like this. So from this options, we need to select use built-in settings option. So display units will be in metric SI system and steel section database will be in Indian system. And steel design code is IS800 code and concrete design code is IS456-2000 code. Click on OK option. The new model quick temples will be open like this. The left hand side section portion will be consisting of grid dimensions data, nothing but your plan data. So story dimensions data is right hand side section. So we need to assume the number of lines in X direction initially. So as per the plan, just I am assuming number of lines will be consisting of 4 lines here. So just I am entering here as 4. So and number of lines in Y direction are 3. So here I am taking spacing between the X direction grid lines as 3 here. Again I am taking the spacing between the Y direction as 3. So after that, click on custom grid spacing option here. So click on edit grid data. So here we need to select the display grid data spacing option. So here I am taking first grid will be consisting of 3 meter. Again I am taking second grid will be consisting of 2.5 meter. So after that we need to click on OK button. So after that, select the story data here. So for this respective building of G+1, it will be consisting of 2 stories. Just I am taking number of stories are 2 here. So typical story height is just I am assuming it as 3 and bottom story height will be 3. Click on grid only option here. So click on OK option. The model will be open like this. The left hand side section window will be consisting of plan view for the respected building and right hand section will be consisting of 3D view for the building. So these are the grid lines for this respected G+1 building. So initially we need to define the material properties. Material properties is nothing but the grade of concrete as well as grade of steel. So initially we need to define those properties. So for this respected building, just I am assuming M30 grade concrete as well as 550 grade steel. So for that, go to define option here, click on material properties. So here we need to select add new material option. So here we need to select the region. Just I am selecting it as Indian system. Material type is concrete here. Just we need to change the steel to concrete. So just I am selecting as Indian, which is consisting of M30 grade. Click on OK option. So after that, click on OK option again. After this, we need to define the steel properties. So further, click on add new material properties here. So again, we need to change the material type from concrete to steel material. So here we need to click on OK option initially. So it will open the respective steel property data like this. Just we need to give the material name as 550 FE 550. So after that we need to select this modify show material property design data. So it will open the properties like this. So from this data we need to change the design property of steel materials here. So just I am selecting this respected FY value will be consisting of 550. Again I am selecting FU value also consisting of 550 here. Click on OK button. So after that, click on OK button here. So here we need to select OK option again. After defining the material properties, we need to define the beam size and column size for this building. Just I am assuming beam size will be consisting of 0.3 cross 0.4 and column size will be consisting of 0.4 cross 0.4. So initially we need to define these two properties. So for that, go to define option here. Click on section properties. So here we need to select the frame sections option. So it will be consisting of some frame sections like this. So initially we need to delete this all frame sections. So select your delete property here. Click on S button. Again select delete property, S button. So here I am deleting all my previous sections. So after that we need to define the beam. So for that, click on add new property here. So here we need to select the concrete section, which is consisting of rectangular shape. This time selecting rectangular section here. So it will open the properties like this. So here we need to give the title initially. Just I am giving the title as 0.3 cross 0.4 is my beam size. After that we need to select the material here. Just I am selecting it as M30 grade concrete. Now we have to select the section dimensions. Just I am selecting it as 300 depth for the beam section, 400 width for the beam section. So after that we need to click on reinforcement. So click on modify show rebar here. Now we have to select design type options here, which is consisting of column as well as beam. So click on beam options here. So after that we need to select the rebar material. So here we need to select this three dots option. So we need to pick Fe 50 grade steel. Click on OK. So here we need to change the longitudinal bars to Fe 550 grade steel and confinemental bars to 550 grade steel. So after that we need to assume the cover for the respective beam sections. So just I am assuming top reinforcement will be consisting of 50 mm. Again bottom reinforcement is also consisting of 50 mm. Click on OK option. So after that click on OK option again. So after that select this respective steel column. Click on delete property. So after deleting this respective steel column, we need to define another section, which is column section. So for that again in the similar way, we need to go to add new property option here. Select the section type as concrete rectangular shape. So here we need to give the property name. This time I'm assuming it will be consisting of 0.4 cross 0.4 is the column. Just select the material as M30 grade here. And we need to give the value of depth as 400. Just I'm giving the value of width as 400. So after that select the modify show reinforcement values. So here we need to select the design type as column section, which is in rectangular section. So after that we need to select the data which is related to longitudinal bars as well as confinemental bars. So here we need to assume the clear cover initially. Just I am taking it as 50 mm. So after that just I am taking the number of bars along two direction or three. So after that we need to select the bar size. So here I am selecting longitudinal bar size will be consisting of 12 mm. So after that we need to select the corner bar size. Just I am assuming it as 16 mm bars. So after that we need to select the confinemental bar dimensions. This time assuming it has 10 mm bars. Click on OK. So it will be consisting of a diagram for the column section like this. Click on OK option. So after that click on OK. So after defining the beam size, column size, we need to define the slab thickness. For that go to define option here. Again select section properties. Here we need to select the slab section. So just we need to delete all these two properties initially. So after that add new property. So here I am giving the slab thickness name. This time I am assuming it as 120 mm. So we need to give the slab material. This time I am assuming it as M30 grade concrete. So here we need to assume the modeling type. Just we need to pick as membrane type from this list. So just we need to assume the property as a slab section, which is consisting of 120 mm thickness. Just I am taking it as 120 here. Click on OK option. So after that select this slab 1 section, click on delete property, S option, click on OK. So after defining the properties like beam size, column size and slab thickness, we need to assign those properties for this respected building. So for that initially we need to select this respected one story option to all stories option. Now we have to select the assignment for the beam sections. Just I am selecting this beam section option. So here we need to select the properties object option, which is consisting of B.3/0.4. Just we need to drag to the respected plan section. So it will assign the beam properties for whole building like this. So after that select the respected I section in order to apply the columns. Just we need to pick the property from beam section to column section, which is consisting of 0.4 cross 0.4. Again we have to drag to the respected structure. So it will assign the respected properties of column for this respected building like this. So after assigning the beam column, we need to assign the slab. So for that go to click on quick draw options here for the slab section. Just we need to select the property option here. This time selecting it as S120 from this respected list. We need to drag to the respected plan. So it will assign this respected slab section for this respected building like this. After assigning the properties for these respected grid lines, we need to delete the slab section at the base for this respected G+1 building. So initially we need to select the properties at the base. So for that go to select your one story option here. So here we need to go to respected zero elevation So here elevation will be consisting of second story, which is of 6 meter. With the help of these arrows, we need to move this respective elevation up direction as well as down direction. So just I'm selecting it as up. So here plan will be showing that z equals to 0, which is nothing but your base for this respected building. Just we need to select all the properties at the base. Click on delete option. So it will delete all the properties at the base for the 3D structure. So after that, again I will go to the top story, which is of second story for this house. So after assigning the properties, we need to see this respected model in rendering view. For that, go to select this right mark option. So here we need to select the extrusion of frames, extrusion of shells option, apply to all windows, click on apply, click on OK. So this is my 3D rendering view for this respected building. So it will be consisting of 0.3 × 0.4 is the beam size, and 0.4 × 0.4 is the column size, and slab thickness will be consisting of 120 mm. So after assigning the properties, we need to define the load cases for this structure of G+1 building. This time assuming load cases will be consisting of dead load, live load, seismic load as well as wind load. Initially we need to define these load cases. Go to define option here, select load patterns option here. So it will be consisting of dead load as well as live load properties like this. So just we need to give the load name as earthquake load in x direction. Just I am assuming it as EX. Just we need to select the type as seismic. So here we need to select the auto lateral load, nothing but the selection of IS code. Just I am selecting IS 1893-2002 code here. Click on add property. So after that, we need to assume the earthquake load in y direction. Again, we have to add new load case. So after that, just we need to define the wind load. Just I am assuming wind load in x direction. Just we need to pick wind load here, which is consisting of IS 875-1987 code. So click on add new property here. So after that, select the wind load in y direction option. Just I am selecting as 875 code. Click on add new property. So after defining these load cases, we need to give the properties as per the assumptions. So just I am selecting earthquake load in x direction option here initially. Click on modify lateral load option. So we need to deselect all these y direction properties. Again I am selecting x direction properties with eccentricity options. So after that, we need to select only x direction. Just we need to assume the seismic coefficient factors as per IS 1893-2002 code. So just I am selecting it as 0.36, nothing but your severe case. Next I am selecting site properties will be in medium condition. Select OK option. Again select earthquake load in y direction. Again select modify lateral load option. Initially we need to deselect all x direction properties. So just I am selecting eccentricity properties here. So we need to pick as 0.36 value, which is of medium side condition. Click on OK. So after that, select the wind load options, select modify lateral load option. We need to define this respected wind load data as per IS 875 code. Just I am selecting the wind coefficient factors here. Just I am selecting it as 44 wind speed meter per second velocity. So after that, we need to assign the terrain category. So it was divided into 4 types depending upon the height of the structure around our building. Just I am selecting it as 4th category. So after that, select the structure class. Just I am assuming it as B. After that, select this modify show property. So here we need to give the direction or angle for the respected wind load. Just I am taking it as 0 angle for here in x direction distance. So after that, click on OK option. Now we have to select the wind load in y direction. Again modify lateral load. Just I am selecting it as 44 meter per second. Just I am selecting it as a 4th category, and structure will be in B class. So select this modify show again. Again we have to select this respected angle. Just I am selecting it as 90 here. Click on OK. Again select OK option. Click on OK option. So after defining the load cases, we need to apply those load cases for this respected building. So for that, initially we need to select all the building. Go to assign option here. Select joint point load. Select as force option here. So here we need to select add to existing loads option. So here we need to apply the loads for the force as well as movement in all directions. Just I am assuming it as 111 is the intensity for the force as well as movement as the dead load case. Click on apply option. Click on OK. So after applying the self weight, we need to apply the dead load for the beam section. So initially we need to select this respected beam structure properties. So go to selection option, select properties, select the frame sections option, select 0.3 by 0.4, click on select option. So we need to calculate the dead load for this respected property. So for that, go to calculator here. So here we need to calculate the dead load of the beam with the help of the dimensions. Just I am taking 0.3 cross 0.4 is my beam size. We need to multiply this beam size with the help of unit weight of the concrete. So it will give the value of 3 kN per meter. We need to apply this respected 3 kN per meter for the beam sections. So click and cancel button. Go to assign option. Select the frame loads here. Select the distributed load. So here we need to select add to existing loads option. Just I am selecting it as 3 uniform load. Click on apply. Click on OK. So it will apply the dead load for the respected beam sections. So after applying the dead load for the beams, we need to apply the dead load for the columns. Go to selection option again. Go to select properties here. Select the frame sections here. Again select column, which is of 0.4 cross 0.4. Click on selection option here. Again go to calculator here. Just I am taking 0.4 cross 0.4 is my column size. We need to multiply this respected column size with the unit weight of the concrete. So it will give the value of 4 here. Again go to assign option, select frame loads here, distributed load. So here we need to select add to existing loads again. Again we have to change the uniform load from 3 to 4 here. Click on apply, click on OK. So after assigning the column dead load, we need to apply the slab dead load for this building. So initially we need to calculate the slab dead load with the help of the thickness. This time taking it as 0.12. We need to multiply this with unit weight of the concrete 25. So it will give the value of 3 kN per meter square. We need to apply to the respected slab section. For that, go to select option here. Click on select. Select the properties. Select the slab sections. Just I am selecting S120 section. Select. Close option. Go to assign option here. Go to select the shell area loads. Uniform load. So here we need to select the load case name as dead load. Add to existing load, which is consisting of this respected value of 3 here. This time assuming it has 3. Click on apply button. Click on OK. So after applying the dead load for the slab, we need to apply the live load for these respected slab sections. So for that, again go to select option. Go to select properties. Again select slab. This time selecting S120. Select option. Close option. Go to assign option here. Again select your respected shell area loads. Uniform load. Just I am changing the dead load to live load here. Add to existing loads. So for this respected G+1 building, just I am assuming live load will be consisting of 2 kN per meter square is the area load which is acting in gravity direction. Click on apply, click on OK. So after assigning the dead load, live load, we need to assign the earthquake load for this respected G+1 building. So for that, initially we need to select all the properties of the building. Go to assign option here. Go to select shell area loads here, uniform load. So here we need to select the load pattern name as earthquake load in X direction. Next I am selecting add to existing loads option here. So here we need to select the direction initially, which is in global X direction. So here we need to select the uniform load intensity, which is 50% of the live load. So 2 divided by 2 will give you 1 here. Click on apply, click on OK. So after that we need to assign the Y direction earthquake load. So for that again select all the building. Go to assign option, again go to shell area loads, again select a uniform load here, earthquake load in Y direction, again add to existing loads, again select global Y direction here, click on apply, click on OK. So after that we need to assign a wind load for this respected building. Select all the properties initially. Go to assign option here. Go to select the shell area loads. Just I am selecting window pressure coefficient here, which is in X direction, which is consisting of 0.8 is the intensity of wind pressure coefficient CP value. Click on apply button, click on OK. So after that we need to assign the wind load in Y direction. Again select all the properties. Go to assign option here. Select the shell area loads here. Again select wind pressure coefficient, which is in wind load in Y direction. Again I am selecting it as 0.86. click on apply, click on OK. So after applying the load cases, we need to apply the fixed supports at the base for this respected building. So for that, initially we need to go to the base of the structure. So here we need to select the one story option. So just I am selecting all the properties at the base. Go to assign option here. joint here. We need to select the restraints, nothing but your selection of supports. So here we need to select the fixed supports option. So it will select all the properties here. Click on apply, click on OK. So after that we need to apply the diaphragm for this respected building of G+1-story. Diaphragm is nothing but the center point of the building as well as load action rate. So for that initially we need to select all the properties. Go to assign option here, select the joint. This time selecting it as diaphragms here. So select respected D1 options, click on apply, click on OK. The diaphragm is visible for this respected plan sections. In order to visible this respected diagram in 3D view, just we need to click on this respected right mark. So click on diaphragm extent option here, click on apply to all windows, click on apply, click on OK. Now the diaphragm is visible for the respected 3D structure also. So after assigning the diaphragm, we need to analyze this respected structure. So for that go to analyze option here. Here we need to check for the errors initially. Click on check model here. So just we need to pick top three options of joint 6. Click on OK option. So here message is showing here like this, model has been checked, no warning messages were generated. Click on close option here. Go to analyze option here. Click on run analysis. So it will analyze this respected model of G+1 building. After analysis is completed, it will show you the deflection diagram of G+1 building in 3D view like this. So click on start animation button. So this is the deflection of the building due to presence of this respected dead load case. I will show you the deflection for various types of load cases now. So further go to display option here, select the deform shape option. So here we need to select the load cases. This time selecting it as live load case, click on apply option. So click on start animation again. So this is the deflection due to presence of the live load case. I will change one more load case, which is earthquake load in X direction. Click on apply, click on start animation again. So this is the deflection of the respected G+1 building due to presence of the earthquake load in X direction case. Again we have to select the respected load cases. This time selecting it as wind load in Y direction. Click on apply option here, click on start animation here. So this is the deflection diagram due to presence of the wind load in Y direction case. So after that click on close option, again select display option here, click on undeform shape. So after checking the deflection values, we need to check the shear force values, bending moment values as well as torsion values for this G+1 building. So further go to display option again, again go to select force and stresses diagrams here, select frame pier forces here. So here we need to select any one of the load cases. This time selecting it as axial force, click on apply. So this is the axial force diagram for this respected G+1 building. Select the torsion option, click on apply. So this is the torsion diagram for this respected building. Go to select shear force in X direction option, click on apply. So this is the shear force diagram. Select shear 3-3, click on apply. So this is the shear force diagram in Y direction. Select moment in 2-2. So this is the bending moment diagram in X direction. Select moment 3-3, click on apply. So this is the bending moment diagram in Y direction case. Click on OK. Again select this respective display option, select undeform shape. So after analysis part is completed, we need to design this respected G+1 building as per IS-456 code. So for that initially we need to select this design option, select the concrete frame design, select view revise preferences option here. So here we need to check the values of the code as well as different properties for the concrete section. Click on OK. So after that select the design option. Again we have to select the concrete frame design. So here we need to select the rebar section rules for the column section initially. So it will open the options like this. So it will be consisting of details of for non-seismic requirements as well as details for seismic requirements. For this building of G+1-story, I was already considered seismic load. So for that reason, I am considering the options which is in right hand side section. So here we need to select the small bar size initially and larger bar size initially. So here I am selecting small bar size will be consisting of 12 mm. Again I am selecting larger bar size will be consisting of 16 mm for the column section. So after that we need to select the ties bar size. So here we need to select the smaller bar size will be consisting of 8 mm. Again we have to select the maximum bar size will be of 10 mm. So this time assuming spacing will be 50 and the spacing of maximum will be 300 here. Click on OK option. Again, we have to select design option, select the concrete frame. Now we have to select the rebar section rules for the beam sections. So it is also consisting of two types of details here, for non-seismic case as well as seismic case. So just I am selecting this bottom portion for this respected seismic case. So here we need to select the smallest bar size initially for top reinforcement as well as bottom reinforcement. Just I am selecting it as 12 mm bars for top reinforcement. So after that we need to select the larger bar size. Just I am selecting it as 20 mm for top reinforcement. Again I am selecting 20 mm for bottom reinforcement. So after that we need to select the preferred bar size here. Just I am selecting it as 16 mm for the top reinforcement. Again I am selecting 16 mm for bottom reinforcement. So here we need to select the minimum number of bars. Just I am selecting it as 2 and 2 for top as well as bottom. So after that we need to select the stirrups data. Just I am selecting the stirrups of 8 mm here, and I am selecting the stirrups of 10 mm for larger bar size. So after that we need to select the minimum spacing as 75 and select the maximum spacing as 300 here as per the assumptions. Click on OK. So after that we need to select the design option here again. Again select the concrete frame design. So here we need to select stat design check options here. Select stat design check options. So it will start designing the respected G+1 building for this respected structure. So this is the reinforcement values for the respected structure. I will show you this respected diagram in 3D view. Select the 3D view option. So this is the area of reinforcement which is provided for different sections of beam and column for the building of G+1. So after that we need to check the values of the reinforcement details for beam as well as column. So for that initially we need to select this plan view. Click on apply button. Click on OK. So select your design option here. Select the concrete frame design here. So here we need to select the display design information. So here we need to select the design output case. This time selecting it as shear reinforcement. This time selecting it as shear reinforcement here. Click on apply option. Click on OK. So it will show you the values of the shear reinforcement for the different types of beams and columns for this respective structure. So after that again go to select your detailing option. So here we need to select the detailing preferences option initially. So it will open the properties like this. So here we need to select this respected options. So here I am selecting units will be in metric system, length will be in meter, section thickness will be in millimeter, and rebar spacing will be in millimeter, force will be in kilonewton here. So after that click on OK option. Again select your detailing option. So here we need to select start detailing option here. Click on start detailing option. So it will design this respected beam and column. So this is the diagram which is related to second story, which is at 6 meter elevation. Now we have to select this respected drawing sheet component view options here. So here we need to select the standard details. So it will be consisting of list of drawings, typical concrete beam elevations and beam section, column section. So initially I am selecting typical concrete beam section of 2S section. So this is my 2A section for this respected beam section. So it will be consisting of two beams for this respected structure. Again I am selecting 3S section. So this is the 3S section which is consisting of three beams for this respected section. So it is also consisting of zones here, which is of zone A, zone B, zone C, again zone B here, again zone A here. So zone A is the corner reinforcement values, zone B is the middle reinforcement value, and zone C is the value of the center reinforcement for the beam section. So after that select the respected beam section AA, just double click on it. So this is the diagram which is related to beam section A. Select the beam section B. So this is the diagram which is related to beam section B. Select beam section C. So this is the diagram. Again select your concrete column typical elevation section. So this is the concrete column typical elevation section for this respected G+1 building. So again select the concrete section AA. So this is the concrete section AA diagram for this respected model. So after that we need to check the reinforcement values for the beam and column. So for that initially we need to select the beam details option, select the concrete beams option, select the schedules and tables option here, select the concrete beam rebar table here. So it is having beam ID, span, span length, size of the beam section. So for the respected A, B, C, D, F, G, H. So it will be consisting of two bars of 14 mm dia, 381 center to center distance for the respected A zone. So it will be consisting of two bars of 14 mm at the B section also. So it will be consisting of some reinforcement values here. So after that, we need to check the values of the stirrups for this respected beam. So this is the stirrups values for the respected beam. It will be consisting of 3 bars of 10 mm dia, 125 mm center to center distance for the respected zone A. So it will be consisting of 20 number of bars of 10 mm dia, 125 center to center distance for the respected zone C section. So after checking the values of the beam sections, we need to check the reinforcement values for the respected column section. So for that, select column detailing options here. Select the column detailing. So here we need to select the framing plans. Select the concrete layout. So this is the column layout for the respected concrete section. Nothing but the center to center distance diagram for the column section. Select the schedule rules and tables here. Concrete column scheduling. So this is the concrete column scheduling for the respected G+1 building. So it will be consisting of column size, section, reinforcement and ties in zone A, B, C here. So it will be consisting of 4 bars of 14 mm dia plus 4 bars of 18 mm dia, which is having 1280 value of reinforcement for the respected column section. And ties will be consisting of 10 mm bars, 100 center to center distance for the respected column section. So after checking the values of the reinforcement value for the beam and the column, we need to check the 3D rendering view for the beam reinforcement and column reinforcement. So for that, select reinforcement gauge view values, select the beam here, select any one of the beam. Just I'm selecting beam number of 2CB1 here, just double click on it. So it will open the diagram like this. So this is the diagram which is related to the beam section, which is consisting of the reinforcement for the beam section of 2S section. So this is the reinforcement diagram for the respected beam structure. So after that, click on cancel button, select the columns here, again select CC1. So this is the column diagram for this respected column section of G+1 building. So it will be consisting of reinforcement diagram for the respected column section. So after that, we need to create the report for this respected project. So for that, go to click on reports option here, select the project report here. So it will load the project report for this building like this. So it will be consisting of each and individual calculation sheet for this respected report. So it is consisting of 79 pages here. So this is the detailed report about the project as per ETAPS 2016 software. So this is the process analysis and designing of G+1 building by using ETAPS software. Thank you.